having the man that you heard just clearing his throat there. It's my friend, Mr. Michael Covington. Michael, good morning.
Good morning, Hugh. Sorry about that.
Oh, but I had to call you. Yeah, I couldn't let that go. Live radio, you know?
Yeah, there you go. There you go.
You doing all right today? Have you been listening to the first hour?
I actually was finishing up a morning workout, and so if I'm a little out of breath, and the reason for the clearing of the throat was I'm just coming in from outside and it's a little cold, but everything's going good. Haven't had a chance to listen to the first part of the program.
Okay, I'm just teasing you about the clearing the throat, man. I'm just teasing you. Welcome in, my friend. Let me, first of all, thank you on such short notice to agree to come on. Let's talk about something very, very important, a continuation of something that you began on last Monday, December the 8th. My guest for the next few minutes is Mr. Michael Covington. He put together a meeting on last Monday. It's called the inaugural East Knoxville Community Meeting that was held at the Burlington Branch Library to talk about the closing of Walgreens and the economic development or lack thereof in East Knoxville. So, Michael, take it away.
Well, Hubert, I'm glad you positioned it just that way. A big part of what that meeting was about was allowing the community to come together first and foremost and to air grievances and issues that the community has. But the underlying theme for that meeting was to change the vision of East Knoxville and in doing so change the perception. I would liken what is happening to East Knoxville to the to pie in accounting and in economics. Pie is equal to or synonymous with profit, and so in East Knoxville, what we've got to do is to change our outlook about business in terms of how we support business, how we attract business, and how we nurture our community's attractiveness to developers and private industry and private investment dollars.
Well, this is a long time coming, but it happens when it happens, and it's happening now. And so, as I said before, your initial meeting on the 8th was just the first of a series of meetings. You were also kind enough to join me on my community television program on last Friday, and we took several phone calls for a 30-minute show. And quite frankly, I was a little bit surprised. And however, I have committed that for the remaining Fridays in this month to continue this conversation about this particular topic. And you have gone ahead and scheduled another mass community meeting for January. So please tell the people about that.
That meeting, Hubert, will be held at the same Burlington branch of the Knox County Public Library. It will be on January 12th at 1:30. What we'll want to discuss is essentially a follow-up to the fact that Walgreens will have closed at that point. We'll talk about the imminent closing of Kroger's. We might as well go ahead and face the fact that that is coming. We'd want to put some perspective on the fact that our research has uncovered that the likelihood is that the Kroger's would be replaced with a second or third tier type market, like a Save-A-Lot or a Super Dollar Value Foods that actually replaced Food City. We'll also touch on the fact that the Toys R Us is closing in Easttown, and that was something that I didn't know about until I heard it on your show. I think it was being announced while we were on air. And just as a side note, the very first caller that called in, the very first caller, actually got information about the meeting from one of the councilmen that received the notice informing folks about the meeting, and he called me and after the show, and then we had a nice long conversation about the fact that it's not just Magnolia that's being impacted by some of what's going on, and the fact that property values in Easttown are compromised by some of what's going on. So there will be that discussion in that meeting on the 12th. Also, I'll be meeting next week with representatives from the Knoxville Chamber of Commerce because we need to actually zero in on the resources that are available to us. And the mayor actually recommended that a part of this effort should be to include the Knoxville Chamber because they have statistical information and a great deal of expertise that can be brought to bear to bring private investment into the area. And then lastly, as I'm remembering just some of the bullet points, we'll talk about access to Magnolia because I think